Let's get to the news.
Roughly 100 Trump supporters gathered outside of Palm Beach International Airport this week to protest President Biden's arrival. Oh, come on. The man's 81. He should be getting a hero's welcome in Palm Beach. Should be like when Free Willy finally goes home. The House yesterday passed the Tax Relief for American Families and Workers Act in a bipartisan vote. Wait a minute, Congress still passes legislation? This is like finding out Billy Joel has a new song out. He does? When asked yesterday about the recent pictures showing red marks on his hands, former President Trump said that he had not seen the photographs and added, quote, maybe it's AI. Okay. Who taught him that? Because now that's going to be his answer for everything. AI. That's AI. AI. Me and Jeffrey Epstein. AI. You can't, AI can't fake that kind of friendship. President Biden's campaign attacked former President Trump yesterday in a post on Truth Social. Wow. They went after Trump on his app. That's like telling your teenage daughter she's grounded in a TikTok. Pennsylvania Senator John Fetterman attended the Washington Press Club congressional dinner yesterday wearing shorts and a tuxedo hoodie, and even that was a rental. Oh, I don't actually own anything this fancy. I haven't seen an outfit like that since the time I was a little kid and our uncle had to stay with us for a while. Let's see how many more of these I can do. He looks like someone typed Shrek Wedding into an AI generator. He looks like he buys his suits at Hugh Joe Boss. He looks like a second-tier wrestler named the Mater D. He looks like Adam Sandler's butler. He looked like he's on his way to find the Zoltar machine from Big so he can get his original body back. All right, that's more than enough of that. Let's get to the serious stuff, and thank you. Thank you for having a little bit of fun out of D.C. Before the bipartisan tax bill passed yesterday, Republican Senator Chuck Grassley said that he did not support the legislation because it could make President Biden look good. And Grassley does not like being shown up by the younger generation. South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem said yesterday that her administration is considering sending razor wire and security personnel to Texas to help deter border crossings. Now's our chance, said North Dakota. A Philadelphia woman was arrested on a Frontier Airlines flight after she allegedly pulled down her pants in an attempt to urinate in the aisle. And because of the arrest, Frontier is demoting her to co-pilot. A 3-year-old boy in Australia was recently rescued from a Hello Kitty claw machine, but it took like an entire roll of quarters. The New York Mets have announced that for the first half of the season, Saturday day games will start at 1:40 p.m. in an effort to bring more families and large groups to the ballpark. Well, I guess that's easier than being good at baseball. The CEO of clothing brand H&M stepped down yesterday from her role, and it's not the first time something at H&M wasn't a good fit. Oh, I guess everybody here is perfectly sized. And finally, according to a new survey, 10% of Americans 65 and older have used TikTok. Of course, most of them think this is TikTok. A Manhattan jury on Friday ordered former President Trump to pay nearly $84 million in his civil defamation case. Well, that explains the new fundraising amounts. Former President Trump said at a rally in Las Vegas over the weekend that he feels, quote, sharper now than I did 20 years ago. Of course, based on all of his testimony, he doesn't remember a single thing from 20 years ago. The White House is set to hold a live-streamed event tomorrow with high school students. The event is called Seniors for Seniors. The Biden campaign is reportedly hoping to get an endorsement from Taylor Swift, though personally, I think they're going about it all wrong. When asked in an interview yesterday about former President Trump's false birther attacks against her, presidential candidate Nikki Haley said, quote, When he feels threatened, he starts to throw all kinds of things out there. Said Trump, she's sleeping with Fauci. California Governor Gavin Newsom said in an interview yesterday that Democrats have done a much better job in recent months of selling their accomplishments and added that the party has the receipts from 3 years of the Biden administration because, like most guys his age, Biden's been keeping all of them in his wallet. Yeah, you never know. You never know. When you're gonna need a receipt to prove you bought something. Just keep it with you. Keep it in your wallet. In a new interview, Republican Senator Tim Scott said that average Americans are, quote, not talking about the lawsuits against former President Trump. You know what else they're not talking about? Tim Scott. Russian President Vladimir Putin was formally registered today for the upcoming election in March, and I've seen enough. With zero precincts reporting, I'm calling it for Putin. A man in California recently set the Guinness World Record for largest collection of hotel key cards, and in a very related story, they finally caught the Sacramento Strangler. I felt the same way when I read it. It makes you laugh at first, and then you're like, oh, well, yeah. Climate activists at the Louvre in Paris over the weekend threw pumpkin soup on the Mona Lisa, though I think it's a little off message to go after a lady who didn't even have a car. Oh, was that the issue? Oh, that joke was cut? Oh, interesting, yeah. Well, I can't say we were proven wrong. So, I'm sorry. So, there's a lot wrong with it, but was the issue that the ring thing was up the whole time? That was one of the issues? Yeah. Certainly going to be an interesting meeting after the show. I hope at least there's one person there who's like, I thought it went good. The doorbell security camera company Ring. Do we want to go to the next graphic or we want to keep that? Listen. The doorbell security camera company Ring announced last week that it would no longer allow police departments to request users' footage, but then reminded customers that they do still have a binding contract with America's Funniest Home Videos. A French tourist at Arkansas's Crater of Diamonds State Park recently found a 7-carat diamond. Wow, that is hard to believe. Someone in France took a vacation to Arkansas? The locals must have been super psyched when they found the diamond. Oh, you look at this. Just a lot. A lot's happened this monologue. I just feel like, I mean, it's almost over, but I feel like we've been through a lot. And finally, a Russian man who flew from Denmark to Los Angeles without a passport last year was found guilty last week of being a stowaway and faces up to 5 years in prison, or worse, a return flight on Alaska Airlines. You guys, I feel like a couple more weeks. Former President Trump's campaign is reportedly focusing its fundraising efforts on recruiting mega donors. Yeah, I wonder why. Suddenly, $50 just ain't cutting it anymore. President Biden traveled today to South Florida for fundraisers in Palm Beach and Miami, while Trump traveled to New York for the exact opposite of a fundraiser. CNN published a report yesterday about the federal government's new energy efficiency standards titled, Joe Biden is not coming for your gas stoves. And I think it's a sign of the times how many headlines sound like things you say to calm your grandma down. Nana, it's okay. There are no hippies in your root cellar. New York Senator Kirsten Gillibrand over the weekend called on President Biden to decriminalize marijuana at the federal level. Though I don't think you're going to get progressive action on marijuana from someone who definitely still calls it reefer.
Yeah, you're better than that. Yeah, you don't want to mess around with that stuff. It's no good for you. It's no good for you.
The producers of the Puppy Bowl have released this year's lineup, and more than 60 dogs will be featured, plus a halftime show by Pitbull. Mike Scollins wrote that joke. I think it's the first joke he ever wrote that I can tell my kids. In a new foreword in the paperback version of his memoir, former National Security Advisor John Bolton criticized former President Trump and said, quote, "A mountain of facts demonstrates that Trump is unfit to be president, and it's never a good sign when a paperback book has the strongest spine in the party." It's a book burn. Elon Musk announced yesterday that his brain science startup Neuralink has implanted a device into a human for the first time, and maybe the last time?
Ding, 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 ding. They've only got 17 seconds to figure this whole thing out, right? Boom. Okay. Missile launch. Pshing. Poom.
Didn't go well. 16-year-old partially blind dog with a heart condition recently went missing. It was found at a local bar about a mile from its home. The dog has since been reunited with its family and was given an honorary country music award. Muslim and Palestinian students at Harvard University filed a federal civil rights complaint yesterday that claims the school failed to protect them from harassment. Wow, things are so weird at Harvard right now that I talked to someone who went there and they didn't even bring it up. I saw Colin Jost in the hallway. He was wearing a Michigan hoodie. Wow, we really did him dirty on the Photoshop. My friend Colin walks like this. We couldn't find a single picture where he was just standing straight. Amazon announced yesterday it will not proceed with the deal to purchase the vacuum maker iRobot due to... Oh, I missed it. Oh, well, I could have just kept going. You guys want to hear the word I missed? Amazon announced yesterday it will not proceed with the deal to purchase the vacuum maker iRobot due to, quote, undue and disproportionate regulatory hurdles. And as anyone that owns a Roomba can tell you, they don't do well with hurdles. In the end, it didn't matter. I was worried my up would ruin the rhythm, but still had such a satisfying landing. Or maybe the joke was never good. We'll never know. Don't you judge me in your corner. Oh, it's easy to judge in the corner. In the corner, you'll stay. Yeah, finally, Krispy Kreme is offering heart-shaped donuts in honor of Valentine's Day. It's the perfect way to tell her, I just remembered what today was. According to a new report, Chinese President Xi Jinping assured President Biden during their in-person meeting in November that China would not interfere in the upcoming U.S. presidential election. Great. You know this election is going to be the worst, even when countries that interfered in previous ones are like, we good. President Biden is set to fly to Michigan tomorrow for a campaign event hosted by the United Auto Workers. But if they ask, he drove. Billionaire hedge fund manager John Paulson is set to hold a fundraiser tomorrow for former President Trump at his $110 million Palm Beach mansion. Why is that guy doing a fundraiser? You clearly have funds. Just give him the money. It's like if you tried to borrow some money from Smaug and he said, well, we could do a car wash. California Governor Gavin Newsom announced new measures yesterday to restore the state's salmon population, and it's a little suspicious that he announced it right after meeting with these lobbyists. Authorities in Connecticut recently arrested a man after he allegedly stole an ice cream truck with $30,000 worth of product inside. He faces up to 10 years in prison with zero chance of being pardoned. A horse in Ohio recently tested positive for methamphetamine, in case you're wondering how they make crazy glue. I'll wait till everyone's done being sad. IBM has reportedly told its U.S.-based managers that they must report to work in person at least 3 days a week or leave their jobs, which is pretty rich coming from the people who basically invented the personal computer. You're the ones who made it so easy to work at home. That would be like Ford saying, you know, we'd really prefer if people came to work by horse. Two men who were stranded on a kayak in the Gulf of Mexico were rescued this week by a Carnival cruise ship, but there was improv that night, so they asked to go back. And finally, in honor of Valentine's Day, Starbucks launched two new drinks yesterday, the chocolate-covered strawberry cream frappuccino and the chocolate hazelnut cookie cold brew. And just like your first Valentine, they'll break your heart. And that was a monologue, everybody.